name is Nikitas Glikas and I am the Vice President of HTC EMEA. And today we launched the HTC One M9. It's the new flagship product from HTC, having all the latest and greatest technologies of the innovation of HTC. Basically, if we would like to be more concise, we can say the first thing is the design, where you can see is the seamless full unibody of aluminum, and you will notice here that it is a dual tone, and this is the first time in the industry where a metal phone can carry two dual tone colors. So we see the silver and the gold. This is the first thing that what you see, and the other thing we have improved is the ergonomy of the phone, how the phone holds and feels in the hand. The second thing is about the Sense, where with the new Sense 7 we are giving bespoke possibilities to the consumers to tailor the phones as they want. So here you can see, for example, I have my favorite painting that I like to have, and you can on top of that, by selecting the painting, the phone automatically selects the right colors that could adjust around the phone. Even the button size and the button colors are also there. Then we have improved the camera. How we have improved? We have introduced a 20 megapixel camera in the back, where we can have a 5x zooming capability. And in front, we have introduced an ultra pixel camera, which this is giving you a great low light experience. For example, you can see here, and I don't have any issues introducing in front of, you can see the experience and the light, even if we are in the dark area, how light, now you can see, how light is the picture within the phone. The third thing is about the sound. So the sound, we have improved the sound quality by introducing the Dolby surround system 5.1, so you can have a real strong and loud sound with a Dolby surround system, a stereo system. And this is why we feel that the proposition of HTC M9 is the greatest proposition in the market. We should not forget it is coming with an LTE up to 450 Mbps download speed, and also it comes with a 32 RAM inside, but it has also the upgradable slot that you can upgrade your memory with another 32, 64, 128, whatever you are carrying from your previous phone or whatever you want to introduce from the market, because we would like to give this experience, and we don't want our customers to be bundled with a specific ROM size that they cannot be upgradable. So this is about the phone.
And what will it be retailing at?
Okay, we will have it in the UAE and the rest of the region by end of March at a retail price of 2749 dirhams. It starts with the silver and gold color, the one you see now. Then we will introduce in probably 2 weeks the gunmetal gray and the full gold edition, which is exclusive for the Middle East and Africa region.
About the growth itself.
Growth, as I said to you, is that we enjoyed the growth of between 2013 to 2014, we tripled our numbers in the whole region. This mainly came from UAE and Lower Gulf, but also from the rest of the regions, from Saudi, from Egypt, and from the Middle East countries. And our expectations for this year is to even double the numbers from where we are coming from. And by having this, we will enjoy a more than 10% market share in the countries where we are focusing. So the as I also said, that with the M9, we enjoyed a more than 10% market share in the super category in specific countries. And now we want, with the compelling desire portfolio, We would like to take this success of the super-end category also towards the lower segments. In regards to competition, what we have seen in the recent months from our competitors or even from Barcelona, we have seen a launch of metal phones, which means that what we HTC was doing from 2010, introducing the first metal phone, which was the HTC Legend, we were on the right direction. So we are a bit flattered that they have selected also to have metal phones, but we are continuing to innovate towards this direction. I know the competition is getting better, is getting stronger, but we don't have anything to fear because HTC is here and it is on our blood to innovate and to deliver the greatest experience ever.
You mentioned of the gold color being exclusive for Middle East region. Will you in a later stage have it as well for global, or it will be?
No, it will be. It will be. As I said, we will first launch here because there is a request also for the rest of the regions to have it also the full gold as a color. But initially we said we want it, and personally me and my Phil Blair has also pushed in order to have it with a time to market in the Middle East region.
You also made a mention of the M8 to be upgraded in 2015.
Yes, the M8 we are bringing a version, which we launched later in 2014, the M8i, which is we are bringing the i experience on the M8 platform, and this one is going to come with some tweaks, new tweaks, a bit of upgradable camera in the back, and we strongly feel that this will also drive the the succession of the M8 on significant numbers also in 2015.
Is there anything you'd like to mention?
Any?
Is there anything else you'd like to mention?
No, basically we are very happy and very excited because HTC is, we are always pushing the edge of our possibilities. We have seen, we launched with Under Armour the HTC Grip. We have launched with Valve the HTC Vive. We have launched the Re camera back in October in New York. And together with M9, we have four different categories that HTC is also innovating. So HTC is a profitable one. We were profitable the last three quarters. So I would say I enjoy very much working in such a nice, dynamic and innovative environment. And I'm very proud that I am leading the sales of HTC in Middle East and Africa.